Hi guys, this video is made by one of our warm-hearted clients. In this video, there is a quick guide about this wireless mini DV camcorder. Except for the mini DV, it includes a lanyard, a USB cable, a card reader, a base and clip for you to fix the DV camcorder on the wall or just place it at the table. For first, please scan the QR code to download the application to your iPhone or Android phone. This is camera lens, and this is power switch. The mobile button here is for resetting the camera. On the back of the main DV, you will find the keyless hole. The micro's cast note nook is here, and the mini USB port is at the bottom. Connect main DV to the power socket using the USB cable and power adapter. In this way, it can work 24/7 days, and even when power goes out, it can still record video locally. Now, let's insert the micro SD card and get started. Push the power switch to the on position and wait a while. The blue inking light will keep flashing. That means being DV's Wi-Fi signal is ready. Open the Wi-Fi setting page on smartphone, click the mini DV's Wi-Fi signal, and input password 12345678. Then, your phone will be connected to the camera. Now, launch the app and tap the 9 icon. If the camera shows online, that means P2P 19 mode setup is successful. Now, let's come to the one mode or remote view setup. Before that, please make sure the P2P19 connection is steady and works properly. Here we go. Tap the arrow icon, click Wi-Fi to go to Wi-Fi page, and choose Use Wi-Fi. Then, tap Search, and click Triangle to sync wearable Wi-Fi hotspot. Input password and tap OK to confirm it. The camera will reboot automatically. Exit the application. Go back to your Wi-Fi setting page on smartphone and connect your phone to another available Wi-Fi network or turn off Wi-Fi and use your mobile network instead. Launch the app again and tap one icon. Then, input account number and password on the back of the mini DV. Tap Launch. If camera shows online, that means one mode or remote view setup succeeds. The red inking light will keep flashing. Then, as long as you get access to the internet, you can access the mini DV whenever and wherever. If you want to record a video to your smartphone directly, you can tap the video recording icon once in the live video page. Hit it again. The video recording will be stopped. Now, you can go back to the one page and click Files to check the video files you got. Tap the arrow icon and choose SD card settings. In this page, please enable start automatic recording and voice recording. Input the desirable video partition size. Then, tap OK to confirm the setting. The camera will record video to the micro SD card continuously.
Check
Changing one notch password avoids others accessing your main DV. On one page, tap the plus icon and choose Update Notch Password in the pop-up window. Then enter new password and tap OK to confirm the change. If for any reason the camera stops working or isn't working properly, a quick reset will restore it back to factory default settings. When the camera is powered on, press the More button for about 5 seconds to reset it back to factory default settings. The camera will restart automatically in 5 seconds. If you want to check video files you got, please power off the camera, remove the micro card and set it into a color reader. Then, insert them into a computer USB port. And now, you can access the video files.